Let me try searching for this instead. Ugh, that has nothing to do with what I searched for. Well, neither does that. Oh, here's something. Oh, I didn't know that. That is interesting. Ah. Wait a second. Okay, that is definitely not true. Is any of this true? Ugh, this was a waste of time. In theory, searching for information on the web should be easy, but if you've ever actually tried it, you know how frustrating it can be. You have to know the right words to search for, then you have to sift through results that have nothing to do with what you're looking for. Then, once you actually find relevant pages, there's no guarantee that the information on them is even true. Experienced internet researchers have basically mastered how to find information on the web, but novice researchers tend to make mistake after mistake while trying to learn new things. And in the end, they may not learn anything at all. By the end of this unit, you'll be a pro at internet research, and the world of knowledge will be yours to research and explore. Let's get into it. People who are just starting to research information on the web make lots of mistakes, and that hurts their chances of finding good information. The lessons in this unit will be focused on teaching you the best ways to conduct internet research, making you a pro, so you can avoid making the most common mistakes. You'll typically conduct your search for information using an information retrieval system, a search engine or database that you can search to find information on any subject imaginable. Beginner researchers use simple search tactics. Type in a few words and hope for the best. But this type of basic search has some significant flaws. It often returns irrelevant results that aren't helpful and leaves out pages that may have been helpful if they had been included in the search results. There are a few tricks you can do to make sure you're getting all the relevant information and only the relevant information. The first lesson in this unit will teach you how to use advanced search techniques to ensure that you find all the helpful results while leaving out irrelevant ones. Forget those beginner tactics. I'm going to make you a professional from the start. Next, novice researchers also tend to believe everything they find online. They don't realize that much of the information they find online is biased, meaning it presents the facts in a skewed or unfair manner that doesn't allow the researchers to fully understand what's going on or come to their own conclusions. So, the second lesson in this unit will be all about how to detect and avoid bias in the information you find online. What's even worse is that some information on the web isn't just biased, it's downright false. Some people publish totally fabricated lies on the internet, and beginner researchers may not know enough to question the lies. In the third lesson of this unit, I'll teach you how to evaluate the credibility of online sources of information, so you'll have the skills to recognize when somebody on the web might be lying to you and which sources can be trusted to tell you the truth. And then, even those beginners who successfully find the unbiased, credible information they were looking for still make a giant mistake. They end up accidentally stealing those ideas from the person who published them. Some researchers even end up getting sued or going to prison for idea theft. Yikes! In the final lesson of this unit, you'll learn how to respect others' intellectual property, the things they created with their own ideas, by using it in a way that is both ethical and legal. In the unit wrap-up, you'll get a chance to show what you've learned by completing a research project from beginning to end. You'll be tasked with finding information sources on the web, evaluating their biases and credibility, and using the information to make your very own creation. By the end of this unit, you'll be a pro at internet research, and all the information on the World Wide Web will be yours to explore and learn. Until next time, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. Hey, hey.